rest in heavenly places in Christ Jesus. And we'll thank you for whatever you do. In Jesus' name, amen and amen.
Amen.
I want to preach a message on wearing his name, but staying the same. Wearing his name, but staying the same.
Fundamentals were based on pamphlets given out during 1910 through the 1915 called The Fundamentals, A Testimony of the Truth. These pamphlets outlined the core beliefs of conservative Christianity. Fundamentals were at war with other Protestant denominations who were very progressive on their views and striving to be relevant to the people of that day. A recent journal article writes about the fundamentalists. In the aftermath of the 1925 Scopes trial, in which fundamentalists went from being respected members of society to a ridiculed group, fundamentalists essentially retreated into their own private world, where they stayed for many decades. The article does not shy away from its bias against fundamentalists. The fundamentalist movement had many leaders who were outspoken against the modernist movement. One such leader is John Frank Norris. Why is he considered one of the most violent and controversial figures in the history of religion in America? Norris was a Baptist preacher and one of the leaders of the Christian fundamentalist movement in the early 1900s. Norris was born September 18, 1877, in Alabama, and his family were farmers. Now, his dad was a violent alcoholic, physically abused Norris. On one occasion, Norris and his father were both shot in 1891 due to thieves trying to steal daddy's horses. This early experience affected Norris into adulthood. Norris then received a personal relationship with Jesus Christ at a Baptist revival at the age of 13. His mom, Mary Davis Norris, was the spiritual rock for the family. In his teenage years, Norris surrendered to the call of ministry, and he attended Baylor University in Waco, Texas, where he studied to become a Baptist preacher. During his years at Baylor, Norris pastored Mount Antioch Baptist Church in Mount Calm, Texas. He continued his education at Southern Baptist Theological Seminary. His next pastorate was at McKinney Avenue Baptist Church, where he saw exponential growth from 13 people to 1,000 people. As he was pastoring, he also became the editor of the Baptist Standard. After a while, he turned in his resignation as editor and became the pastor at First Baptist Church of Fort Worth, Texas, where he would serve 43 years until his death. Norris had a popular radio ministry. He had a revival ministry stretched across the United States, and he also traveled overseas on many mission trips. Norris also was innovative because he did multi-site churches before there were multi-site churches. He pastored two large churches simultaneously. One such church was Fort Worth, Texas, and the other was located in Detroit, Michigan. Later on, he did die of a heart attack in 1952. Well, what made Norris controversial? He was indicted of arson and perjury due to his house and church being destroyed by fire, but he was later found innocent. He became a leader of the fundamentalist movement, and he began attacking anyone who supported progressive ideas on the Bible, such as evolution, communism, and Catholicism. One of his attacks was toward his former college, Baylor University. His attacks were so intense that Norris and his church were denied for 2 years the ability to even attend the Baptist General Convention of Texas. Now, Norris was very dramatic in his sermon presentation and very flamboyant in his use of object lessons. For example, here's some list of things that he brought into the pulpit. He brought monkeys one day. He burnt Nazi flags in the pulpit. He even brought a funeral casket full of whiskey bottles. On one occasion, he verbally attacked the mayor of Fort Worth, which caused a friend of the mayor's to visit Norris at his church office. This encounter turned violent, and Norris shot and killed the mayor's friend. The government indicted Norris for murder, and his church supported him and believed he was innocent and raised money for him. The jury very quickly found Norris not guilty due to self-defense. Norris is also well known for fiercely combating the Southern Baptist Convention, as he felt they were breeding liberals in their seminaries and their churches. Norris may have been controversial, but he led the way in returning many churches to believing in the authority and truthfulness of Scripture.
They identified with, amen? Yeah. Then we got some that don't wear enough clothes. Yeah? We got more of that going on today than we've ever had before. Then we've got those that wearing makeup, amen? They're not satisfied with the way God made them, so they